end cards can help push people towards your next video, can boost watch times, can funnel people into playlists. But they've moved it in the YouTube studio, so I'm here to teach you how to add end screens in the new YouTube studio dashboard area. Here we go. Hello and welcome back to another video. I'm Alan Spicer, your YouTube certified expert. And if you're looking to start a YouTube channel, grow your YouTube channel, or push your brand out there onto the second largest search engine on the internet, you should click subscribe, start creating. One of the most powerful features on YouTube for any creator is the end screen. You know, you've seen it for either me or many other YouTube creators. It's at the end of their video. For the last 20 odd seconds, stuff will pop up here for you to go and click on, for you to go and subscribe, to go and you check out playlists or other channels that may have been suggested. But in the new YouTube studio, they're now hidden under the editor tool and not in their own end screen card feature. So I'm here to teach you how to add and edit your existing end cards on the new YouTube studio. Let's go to the computer. Okay, so this is the new YouTube Studio. On the left-hand side, you'll see videos. You should be used to this page. This is where it lists all of your video content. And then you choose the video you want to add your end screen to. So in this case, it's going to be this one. Once you've clicked on the title, it will load you into your screen. You know, where you add your title, your descriptions, your tags, your thumbnails. What we're focusing on is the editor option on the left-hand side. This is the editor. Now, it's a little bit more advanced than you're used to for the previous version, but it's still quite easy to use. You'll see if you scroll down, there's the option to add end screen. It will ask you to pick a default template. Now, you can use any of the setups here in which it auto-fills them. It shows you one video playlist, one link, one subscribe. Or in my case, I'm going to use the blank template to start so you can pick your very own. Now, on the far right-hand side, you'll see that it's filled in four boxes. Here you go. This gives you the four options for whatever you choose to put in there. And you can zoom in using this thing here. You zoom across. You find where you want it to go in the video by using the drag bar. In my case, I have a specific end screen, so I want it to go on the white and the red. If I click on it, it gives me the right to choose video, playlist, subscribe, channel or link. In this example, I'm going to do video, and you'll see that it clips it to where I chose to start that thing. And over here, I can choose most recent video, best for viewer, or choose a specific video. If I choose a specific video, it pops up and I can choose any of my content. So in this case, let's say I want that one. Auto fills it in, you can see how it is, and I can pull it around and make it as big or as small as it allows me to do so. If I want to add another element, I simply click on the next bit, and then I either choose, say, playlist. At the moment, you can add any playlists. I'm not sure if you're supposed to be able to do that. It might just be a bug. So I'm typing in Alan Spicer, and it lists all of the playlists with Alan Spicer. Most of those are mine, some of them are not. And once again, for this example, say I do the Feel More Confident on Camera playlist. So I click on that one. It fills it in on the preview. I can drag it over to where I want it to be. And then I move on to the next one. You'll notice because it played a little bit, it's moved there. If I want to stretch out to where I want the video to be, wait until you get the two arrows either side and I can stretch it. Once again, adding a third, I can add a link or I can add a subscribe button. Subscribe button will be immediately yours. And you can see whether it auto-fills itself in when you hover over it and it shows you where it'll pop up. So in that case, it will cover most of my face. If I put it down there, it'll cover most of my chin. But you can line it up and you can see where it goes. Make sure they're not overlapping, because if you overlap them, you'll notice, see, they go red. And when you are ready, you simply click save. It will say that these changes are irreversible and you click save.
So now you can update your own end screen and end cards and start pushing people to playlists and channels and just generally keep your channel up to date. If you need any help with any of the YouTube features that may boost your channel or help you, you know, trim your video, there's a playlist up here. And remember to subscribe for regular YouTube tricks and tip tutorials. Hit that notification icon so you're alerted every time I go live. Go out there, start creating.